I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. The hatred runs deep between these teams, and no position feels the pressure of a rivalry game more than quarterback. Can this fella look past the emotion of the game and deliver a victory for his team? It's the Bengals going up against the Ravens. So for the call of this week's 17 matchup, let's send it out to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we are coming to you from the heart of Baltimore, nestled between Russell Street and I-395. We're at M&T Bank Stadium. Today, the curtain falls on the regular season, and we've got a good one in store between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Baltimore Ravens. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you look at this Raven team as they get ready here. They were winners last time. And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. Looking to throw. Brought in here by Tyler Eifert. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. Give him 8 on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Still in search of the first down after that last completion. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the grab by Croft. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. He got 18 yards. Let's go, D.
Let's go.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Out on the right, this is Cruz. Give him 27 yards that time. And the Bengals are going to have a first down.
Everything in the spot. Excellent coverage. Didn't leave him enough room to come down inbounds, even though he did catch the football.
They'll drop to throw. He's got Cruz complete. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
One receiver left, two to the right. Back to throw now on first down. Dancing to his left. This one grabbed by A.J. Green. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. And they better put that ball to the side, because with that catch, he's a new single-season receiving yards record holder.
What a fantastic year. And we saw it start early, didn't we, partner? Right out of the gate, we knew he was going to have a tremendous year, but who knew it would culminate in breaking this all-time record.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. To the left side here for Eifert. And he's brought down. 11 yards on the pickup, and it'll give the Bengals a first down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
They'll come out in the pistol. They'll look to throw here on first down. Trying to lay one up deep. And this is caught. They give him a gain of 38.
It was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Giovanni Bernard, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bengals are in for 6. Well, we heard it, how heavily they stressed effective goal line offense this week in practice. Pays off there, they punch it in.
Now not only have we heard it.
Got it, got it!
They go back to the air here after the INT. Forced out to his left. So we've reached halftime here on New Year's Eve as we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Ravens have been solid in the secondary to this point. The Bengals have struggled to throw the football two straight weeks, so that's something they'll try to fix in the second half. All right, let's do it. Here's a look at the first half highlights. Bengals heading out on their opening drive. They're going to come away with another sack. This will go for a loss of seven. Now first and 10. The quick pass and completion is made, and he'll end up picking up 38 yards on the play. Bengals later on the drive. Bernard's by himself here, and this play will go for six. Bengals up now by seven. And with that,
they'll try and start this drive in the air. Flush to his right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. A.J. Green with touchdown number 20 on the year, and the Bengals add on to their lead.
Okay, the highlights are going to show the guy throwing it, the guy catching it, and ended up in the end zone. But how about those big guys up front that allowed that to happen? He had a ton of time to throw the ball.
He did. There's two sides to that coin, though. The O-line was great, D-line not very good.
And as well as coverage, because now you're really stuck in a bad spot. That much time to throw the ball, someone usually comes free.
They're going to look to throw. Flushed out right. And the catch made. It's Tyler Boyd. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there. The football, he can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
He's back to throw. Caught. It's Cruz, left side. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can...
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Another pistol look here. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
And we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
The setup to throw. And Green with a catch left side. And he is in for the score. Absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime. As the fans exit back out through the turnstiles, not happy looks on their faces. Feel like they probably let this one slip away at home in overtime.
I would agree with that, and their unhappiness hurts the guys at the concession stands on the way out, right? Not stopping to buy something for the kids. They just want to get home. But what a dramatic way to finish this bad boy off. I mean, this game was dramatic all the way through. That's why we got to overtime. And then to go ahead and finish it this way, the fans screaming out unhappy.